Today's build is going to be the lovely 65 Pontiac Bonneville Sport Coupe. It's a 3-in-1. You can build it as a bone stock Bonneville. You can build it as a mild custom. And you could build it as a, step back, huge, complete, different custom. It even includes parts for a custom interior. So talking about parts, let's get in there. Let's see what's going to be in the box. We're going to go through the small parts first. You'll see a bunch of the custom stuff on there. We've got bucket seats. We've got all the trim with the exhaust outlets along the bottom. We got some wheels on there. We got a custom console. We've got our stock seats and console for the front. We've got a blockout. If you want to build this as a curbside in a stock Bonneville, you can just put this on the bottom of the chassis with the bottom of the engine, glue the hood on, and be done with it. Makes for a very nice, quick build. There's nothing wrong with making a curbside model. That's the stock hood. Looks lovely underneath there. Even has hood insulation up underneath there. And the detail on that seat and console is definitely presentable. We've got engine package here. Big V8. Transmission, we've got custom headers, we've got stock manifolds, heads, intake, custom intake, stock intake, exhaust outlets, exhaust pipes that will go down to the chassis from the stock manifolds. You got all kinds of goodies on there, including the battery. On this one, we've got more custom parts. Check out that. Wow. Look at that. Look at that. Grill on that thing, or the bumpers. Holy bejeebus. Wheel covers. We got a custom hood fit around that custom grill like that. Ay caramba. You really can go nuts with these. You can cut out your hood if you want. Get those carburetors sticking out through the top. Just go nuts. We got our stock dashboard. Looks awesome. Steering wheel. If you want to make this thing a drop top, there you go. Start hacking into it. You can just get out the knives and start cutting in it and making it your own. We got the firewall. We got, looks like, seat belts here. Those can be used stock or custom. Bumper pans. Custom front end parts. Firewall is really detailed for this kind of a kit. Really detailed. Our interior tub has your basic door details, ribbed for your excitement, nice back seat, whoa, we'll get out for a little bit for the camera, nice back seat detail, door panel there, we've got a one-piece chassis with exhaust, you know I don't mind these at all, dry brushing and some detail painting on the sides and everything, make them look absolutely fine for me. Look at the thing is enormous and the body's going to be even bigger. Da-dun! Massive, massive cars from General Motors back in the day, and Ford and Dodge. But this thing is extensive. Huge. Nice strong detail on there. No issues with any of that. Even the trunk seam is strong. Our trim is large with a definitive line. We can get that painted in there and detailed. Nice looking hot rod, nice machine. How long is that thing? Just the body without any bumpers on it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8¾ inches just for the body? Yowza. Big, big cars back in the day, and the parking spots were still the same size. On this side, we've got steel axles to support the weight of all that plastic. We've got transparent red taillights. We've got a one-piece glass system. Headlights and custom covers, all in there for your amusement. We've got a beautiful chrome tree. We've got stock bumper and front end. Nice custom wheels. Looks like stock wheels, or maybe these are the stock. We've got all kinds of custom parts on there. We'll get in real close so you can see everything that's included. Stock bumpers, tail lights, light surrounds. We got a nice mirror detail there. Just so you get a real good look at everything and those wheels, grill. We got an awesome decal sheet. Look at all the stuff that's on there. Most important to me, the Bonneville logos, the Pontiac logos, the engine detail. Does that say 421? 46? I'll have to check that out later. We got our control decals, radio, all the pod gauges, and the sweeping dashboard, along with sponsor decals, stripes, names, flames, Bonneville motors, Bonnie Sass name on there. I mean, you've got it all done, and we really appreciate when the logos and all that are done for us. Saves a lot of detail work. The last part is the tires. You get two entire sets of tires, pad printed, white wall Firestones, black wall on the other side if that is your style. Nice bias plies on there. Beautifully done. Those are a solid tire. They're mostly solid. You can see they're open in the center. And then some nice, soft, authentic BF Goodrich radial TAs with the correct triangle tread of the TAs. The letters are very prominent. You could white letter those quite easily with a white chalk pen, and you are all set. So I'm going to start building my Bonneville, and I'll be right back. 45 minutes at best, is what it takes to assemble the 65 Bonneville if you're going to do a beautiful stock car. Now, we got the hood just kind of sitting up there. That needs to be body color. We've got another body part sitting around here somewhere. That sounds like something a serial killer would say. It's actually the nose piece that will go in between the grill here. That has to be painted body color. I must have misplaced it for the second, but I'll find it again. Once I get into the paint booth, we'll get that painted up. Kind of wondering where that disappeared to. We've got the radiator support, the battery, and the radiator itself. Now, according to the manual, that should be black. Under the body, there is a very, very distinct set of marks where that needs to go. So that we'll be able to glue in after the fact quite easily and put that in so we can get that. The firewall lines up on a real thin line underneath here to hold the back of the hood up. I did glue it in with model glue at this point so that it is a very rigid assembly. It will also help when I put the body on the stand on the spreader so that it doesn't open up the body too much and warp it out of control or break any trim or anything like that. Then I will go in and I will hand paint that. That's not a problem. I do that all the time. I also have the wheel skirts in. I don't like wheel skirts. If it was my Pontiac Bonneville, I'd remove them the minute I pulled out of the dealership lot, but I wanted to build it up as close to factory stock as I could. I don't do perfect restorations. The wheel skirts do fit in, or the fender skirts, whatever they want to be called, do fit in a little awkward, but once you get model glue in there, just push them in and they will line up nicely so that that trim is one continuous line and you have the nice seam there. I'm not going to build them so that I can detach them. They are glued in permanently. The wheel backs are ready to go. That's all I'm really saving for that. The belt pulley and alternator are all set. I will hand paint the alternator itself. I wanted to glue that in. And unlike a lot of older kits, the alternator actually has a bracket, a mount for it. So that's pretty unique on that. These are the exhaust pipe extensions you'll need to go from the exhaust on the chassis to the exhaust manifolds coming out of the engine. Don't lose those. Get those painted up in your exhaust tone. We've got the seat belts all cut out, ready to go. The dashboard and the steering wheel will all be the same color, so we can just hold on and paint those. The seats and the console for now will all be the same color as the interior. I will then go in and repaint the package shelf and the flooring by hand without masking those off. And folks, that's it. The manual says that these are the stock wheels, so that's what I'll be using with the stock front and rear bumpers and that little nose piece I have to go find because I'm not sure where it is and it's not hiding underneath anything here. So I will find it. I haven't tossed any of the parts yet. They're all gently put aside. So I will hit the paint booth, find my missing part, and we'll be right back. Well, this is pretty fun because while I've been finishing up this car today, they've been running a marathon on The Sopranos on HBO, and one of the cars in one of the flashbacks when Tony Soprano is looking at some dudes, one of the cars that's sitting on the side of the street is this car. Not in gold, but it's the same model, 65 Bonneville. So that was pretty cool to see that going on. Anyways, let's get to the model build. All I've got to do is just really push things together, a little bit of gluing things together towards the end, and then we're all done. Very, very easy build, as are most of these promo style kits with an engine, and they make for a nice looking car when we get done. So at the end, all I've got to do is put on the Bonneville logos towards the back. I've got to put on the fender logos towards the front and the Pontiac arrows on the front and the back of the car. And then that is it, because I've already got the dashboard done. As you saw, I've got that decaled with the gauges, the heater controls, and the radio. And then I highlighted that, and that's got that fake wood grain in there. Now, the steering wheel was like a clear style, but what I did was I used almost the same technique with craft paint of a light brown for that clear steering wheel, and then clear coated it with a semi-gloss spray like you saw in the painting section, and then did the same over that faux wood once the decals had dried. And we have a nice looking dashboard, very functional, very attractive looking. The back end of the car is all done. Got our tail lights in, got our reverse lights marked. The grill is all set to go. I did find that little piece, got it painted, and inserted it in the center. So we are all set to go on the nose of the car as well. We've got the interior done. The seat belts really add detail. I love that they're in there. Got the center console in there with the black carpet and the white interior. So that looks nice, and you'll see a lot of shadow in there because I did a lighter white, or that winter gray coat over that. So it wasn't stark white in scale. I didn't want it to be super, super white in this one. I wanted it to be a little off and show a lot of that tuck style, that roll interior. I wanted that to show off. We've got the chassis all done. That 421's a lovely looking engine. And I did use the turquoise. You could use other blues or light blues or whatever. Whatever looks close to you. Got those exhaust pipe extensions glued on so we can have the stock exhaust. Got the exhaust painted. And then I like to dry brush the bottoms of my chassis just to bring out all that lovely molded detail instead of just black. I like to do that on them. Got our wheel and tire combo. Had to go with the white walls on the new Pontiac. And then the hubcaps on there, the wire wheels or whatever they are. Those look lovely on there with the black wash inside. And then the body itself. Got the firewall. Got the radiator mount. Got the battery in there. Got the glass glued in. Did the trim with the Molotow pen. When covering a larger surface area, it's easier to paint it on with that Molotow pen than it is to use a Sharpie. The Sharpies don't like those large areas, but doing the trim is very easy to do with the Sharpie, easier than the Molotow, and it's much more durable as well. So that is it. Super easy. I'm going to get the final assemblies done, get those little bit of decals on there. I'm going to brush two coats of Future Floor Polish on. It's exactly how I do it. I brush it on and then walk away, like I've told you guys 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 million times in videos. That's as simple as it is. I don't hide steps or make things up. So we'll get that all put together, and I'll see you in a little bit. Round two models, 1965 Pontiac Bonneville Sport Coupe. Looks pretty tight in the rose gold with the off-white interior, the black carpet, the black package shelf, and that nice dashboard done up with the wood grain. Really, really like it. The decals went on super easy, and I was very surprised. You can see them clearly. A lot of times on the lighter color paintwork, you put those silvery decals on and they sort of just disappear. But not on this one. We got the fender decals. We got that big Bonneville name. There's no way I could paint that on there to look that nice. We got the arrowheads, the Pontiacs there. We got the nice logos and the taillights. Really like that they have transparent red instead of clear and having to paint it. Everything goes together super easy. It's not a challenge at all. Not a problem putting that kit together, making it look nice, and having it on display. I did a stock one, so I did use the fender skirts. You could eliminate those. You could do whatever you want. And, of course, you could do your super custom 65 Bonneville. It's a 3-in-1 kit. The entire box has a gajillion extra parts left over in it for the custom and customizer seats and an extra set of tires going on over here and all kinds of stuff. And we got a real set of radial TAs, which you don't see a lot very often in the box. You got the awesome mega sized decal kit with all kind of gauges left over and everything. So the kit's a joy to build. You get wheel options, you get engine accessory options, you get seat belts for the interior. You got all kinds of stuff in the box. Nice heavy box full of styrene. I thank Round 2 Models for sending this over. This is on pre-order right now, so I will link you to the websites. It's not available on the market at this exact second when this video comes out, but it should be coming out within the next 4 to 6 weeks usually. Might come even sooner, I suppose, depending on where those big shipping crates are in the world at this time. So again, thanks Round 2 Models for sending this over. Their kits are always fun to build. The classic cars, people just love them. The 65 Bonneville should be a huge hit with all the extra stuff that's in that box. Almost enough to build two kits, not quite, but you know what I mean. You know, we got extra package shelves and all, you know, all kinds of accessories for the inside and outside and wheels and tires and special bumpers and bumper covers. It's just insane, all the stuff that's in there that we went through in the parts review. So, as always, remember, it's just a hobby. Smile. Build your kits for you. And number 4, I will see all of you at the next review.